Welcome students, how are you? I hope you will be fine at home. Today we are going to discuss about an interesting topic and important topic also. Name of the topic is nouns gender. Name of the topic is nouns gender. Today we are going to discuss about gender of a noun. There are how many type of gender and what are they and how we can use in practically by which we will be secure good mark in exam. Look at the wide world. In world, nouns can classify into two parts. In world, according to gender, noun can classify into only two parts, like living or non-living. One is living, another one is non-living. Living, if any noun is living, then the living noun may be male animal. Living noun may be male animal. Living noun may be female animal. Living noun may be either male or female animal. Or non-living noun, neither male nor female animal. Okay. To male animal, we can say masculine gender. Masculine gender. To female animal, we can say feminine gender. Feminine gender. And to the noun which is neither male or female, we can say that this is common gender. Common gender. The noun which is either male or female, we can say that common gender. And the noun which is neither male nor female, to this type of noun we can say that this is neuter gender. Neuter gender. So let's start discuss about one by one, to whom we can say masculine gender, to whom we can say feminine gender, to whom we can say common gender, to whom we can say neuter gender. We discuss that according to gender, a noun can be classified into four parts. Number one is masculine, second feminine, common and neuter. Let's start discuss one by one. Number one is masculine gender. Masculine gender means a noun that represents male animal. A noun that represents male animal is called as masculine gender. For example, father, boy, horse, brother, dog, it is like that. Second one is feminine gender. A noun that represents female animal. A noun that represents female animal, it is called as feminine gender. For example, mother, cow, sister, girl, wife, like this. Next one is common gender. Common gender means a noun that represents either male or female, it is called common gender. For example, name of post like teacher, doctor, police, friend, relatives, like this. Next one and last one is your neuter gender. Neuter gender is non-living things. The noun which is non-living, to that non-living we can say neuter gender. And neuter gender, a noun that represents neither male nor female, it is called neuter gender. For example, table, chair, building, books, like this. There are some rules to formation of noun, masculine to feminine. Rule number one is, by adding ess to the masculine, we can convert into feminine gender. Okay, for example, priest, priestess, host, hostess, lion, lioness, baron, baroness. Second rule is, sometimes there is a slight change in the spelling before adding ess. By a slight change in the spelling and add ess in the masculine noun, masculine gender, we can convert it into feminine gender. For example, emperor, empress, we change orr to ess and we add ess. Another, conductor, conductress, instructor, instructress, prince, princess, like this. Third rule is, feminine gender of nouns that are compound nouns, compound words. Feminine genders of nouns that are compound words, like grandfather, grandmother, he got, she got, man servant, maid servant, like this. Next rule is, some words that change entirely to change masculine to feminine gender. For example, boy, girls, brother, sister, king, queen, lord, lady, husband, wife, son, daughter. In this way, we can change masculine gender to feminine gender. There are some nouns, there are some common gender nouns like artist, pilot, anchor, painter, lawyer, baby, child, cousin, companion, friend, judge, driver, poet, author, actor, cook, singer, player, pupil, tutor, student, reporter, person, organizer, doctor. I hope you understand better. Today we discuss about gender of nouns and formation of plurals. How to formation of plurals of a noun. How to convert masculine gender to feminine gender. That's all about today's class.